This week on Maker Update, gesture-controlled holograms, a new magazine for makers, a chill drink bot, a DIY solar battery, and a cool tool for soldering circuit boards. It's Wednesday, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome to another Maker Update. Hope you're all doing well. Here in the Bay Area, it's starting to finally feel like fall, which is making me feel motivated to wrap up all the projects I wanted to get done this year, so that's where my head is at right now. I've got a great show for you this week, so let's get right into it, starting with the project of the week. Over on Hackster.io, the team at Hacker House has a guide and a video showing how they made this holographic music visualizer that responds to gesture control. The project uses a computer monitor connected to a Mac that runs the visuals. That gets projected down to a pyramid of acrylic sheets that have been set at exact angles to achieve the 3D effect. The base includes a Raspberry Pi connected to a Flick board that handles the gesture control and sends out the control data to the Mac over a local network connection. It's definitely an involved build with woodwork, electronics, coding, 3D printing, and cutting acrylic. On top of that, depending on what size monitor you use, all of the math for the 3D effect has to be recalculated, and the equations for that recalculation have yet to be posted on the project page. Still, what a cool project. I'm excited to see this out there, and it's totally something I'd love to have in my house. And now for some news. The Raspberry Pi Foundation has announced the launch of a new monthly magazine called Hackspace. It's going to be published alongside Magpie, which they also handle, and will feature a broad range of DIY projects beyond the world of Raspberry Pi. The first issue is out at the end of the month, and you can sign up now to get one, though shipping comes from the UK, so it will cost you a little bit to get it. Fortunately, just like Magpie, each issue will also be available as a free PDF. A few more projects to share. Check out the Chilled Drinky Bot by John Park on Adafruit. You pour a drink, flip the switch, and press the button, and the base quickly chills the drink using a Peltier cooler and a computer fan. Once a preset temperature has been reached, the Trinket M0 board controlling everything turns on a peristaltic pump that dispenses the now cold drink into a different cup. It's literally a cool project, especially if you're into cocktail robotics. There are a few panels to either laser cut or template out on wood, but nothing too intricate. Every other part can be ordered directly from Adafruit. While you're at it, Becky Stern has another solar project on Instructables that's also chock full of Adafruit parts. It's a solar charged battery pack. Inside the project box, you have a solar battery charger board which trickles power over to a 3.7 volt rechargeable battery. Then you have a power boost board that takes the charge battery up to a regulated 5.2 volts for the USB output. Solar power comes in through whatever size solar panel you can get, which hooks in through a barrel jack connection. Becky also adds in a nice illuminated power switch so you know when things are charging up. The whole thing is a clear, low-stakes project that requires just a little bit of soldering, and the payoff is some extra confidence around working with solar panels and rechargeable battery projects. Personally, I love the idea of my projects being able to harvest their own energy. It's time for another cool tools review. This time, we're taking a look at this circuit board holder from Avin. I got this for $12 on Amazon, and if you want this exact same one, you can use the link in the description, which helps support my videos, and the Cool Tools blog. Helping hands tools are really a matter of personal taste. None of them are perfect, and this one's no different, but for the price, it really nails a couple of cool tricks. The first one is that once you secure an unpopulated circuit board in here, wedging it in the grooved spring-loaded grippers, you can quickly flip it back and forth. This is great when you need to drop in a component from the front, bend the leads, flip it over to solder it up, and then flip it back for the next component. With this, it's easy. There are thumb screws to tension everything up just the way you want, and it sure beats working off a table, and it's more rigid than a flexible arm clip. The second thing this is great for is desoldering components. If you screwed up and you need to take something out, you can heat on one side and pull or pry from the other. Or if you're using a solder sucker, you can really just rest your hand on this thing and get right up to the spot without having to chase it. That's all there is to it. It's a simple and inexpensive tool, but relatively well built, and I'm surprised I don't see them more often. You can pick one up using the link in the description, and remember, you can see thousands of reader recommended tools like this at cool-tools.org. I have some more tips to share with you. Over on Adafruit, the Ruiz brothers have a guide on making your own solder masks on homemade circuit boards. This helps preserve the copper on the board, gives you a more professional look, and it keeps the solder where you want it. On his blog, Jay Carlson reviews 21 different microcontrollers that cost $1 or less. These are not beginner-friendly boards, but it's cool to see what's out there at this price, and Jay is definitely thorough. Over on YouTube, I came across some useful videos by Eric Striebel. One is this video with 7 tips for resin casting, from which containers to use to what to do with leftover resin. Eric also has this great guide on modeling prototypes with foam core. One trick in particular is to cut a grid into a sheet of foam core to loosen it up and allow it to create complex curves. There's a lot of great nuggets in here. And of course, Gareth Branwyn's Tips of the Week column on Make is a treasure trove of cool ideas. One of my favorites is this one from Barb Noren on using shrink plastic in a toaster oven to make name tags and charms, or even recycling number 6 plastic from takeout containers to do the same thing. Maker Faires, a deceptively light week for Maker Faires this weekend. You have Shenzhen, China, Wolfsburg, Germany, Buenos Aires, Argentina, Akron, Ohio, and Sindelfingen, Germany. But on top of that, this weekend there are also little Maker Faires in Barnes & Noble stores nationwide. So check with your local store and see if there's a little Maker Faire happening. And that's it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave me a thumbs up, leave me a comment. Sign up for the email list, the Maker Update email list, which goes out every Wednesday with all the links, plus some extra links for stuff I couldn't fit. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.